about the elements and compounds. Already we know that in this nature, any element, anything we take, anything is made up of the atoms. Already we have discussed about the atomic structure. And what is the difference between element and a compound? Let us know what is the difference between an element and a compound. For example, if you take oxygen, oxygen is oxygen atom. If I just write one single oxygen, that is oxygen atom. But oxygen will not exist in nature in the atomic state. So it always exists in a molecular state. Means oxygen, the two atoms of oxygen combine together to give rise to an oxygen molecule. So generally what we breathe, these are oxygen molecule, not the oxygen atom. So this is an element. Why this is an element? Because it is not combining with any other atom. For example, if you take water, water is nothing but H2O. Means now the oxygen is combining with two hydrogens. So here it is a compound because it is having two different varieties of atoms. This is an element because it is having only one variety of atom is combined. I think now you. For example, you take a nitrogen. N2, nitrogen cannot exist in the atomic form. It always two atoms of nitrogen combined to form nitrogen molecule. In nature, we get nitrogen in the mostly in the form of nitrogen molecule. N2 is an element because it is made up of, this molecule is made up of only one variety of atoms. For example, HNO3, nitric acid, it is a compound. It is a compound because in this compound there is hydrogen atom is there, one nitrogen atom is there, three atoms of oxygen is there. All combined together is a nitric acid we see. So that is a compound, whereas nitrogen is an element. For example, iron, you take magnesium, if you take sodium, Na, if you take potassium, these are all the elements because they are not combining with anything else. But if you take magnesium oxide, MgO, again it became a compound. If you take sodium chloride, NaCl, again it becomes a compound because it is combining. In this case it is combining with oxygen. Here it is combining with chlorine to give rise to sodium chloride. So these are the compounds and these are the individual atoms. The molecule is formed out of the individual atoms. These are called the elements. Now I think you might have understood what is the difference between an element and a compound. So my dear friends, in chemistry, when we handle with chemistry, when we go with the chemistry, we must have some minimum idea about some how to write a formula. For example, what is a valency? We should know what is a valency. We should know what is an atomic number, molecular atomic weight, molecular weight. We should by heart, to some extent we should by heart. And even we should know how to write if I say sulfuric acid or sulfurous acid or hydrogen sulfide, nitrogen sulfide, or if you take potassium chloride, potassium chlorate, potassium nitrate, potassium nitride, potassium nitride. See, there are so many different compounds are there. If a name is given, you must know how to write a formula. Or if a formula is given, you should know how to write the name of it. So this knowledge, this is an elementary knowledge in chemistry. This is an elementary knowledge in chemistry. To have this knowledge, one must know the formula, or one must identify what is it representing in the periodic table, the symbol of it. We must know the some symbols are basing on the names. Some symbols are basing on the Latin names. Some are basing on the name of the scientists. Some are basing on the name of the country. Some are basing on the name of the planets. So in that way, the names, while naming, there are different parameters are taken while naming and giving a name to it. So all of you know this, but still I am trying to tell you. This is hydrogen, Generally, the symbol of hydrogen is the first alphabet H. That is the symbol of hydrogen atom. If you write molecule, that is hydrogen molecule is H2. I am not talking about the molecule. I am only talking about the symbols. That's all. This is carbon. The symbol is C, the first alphabet. Nitrogen. I request all the children, please write it down and by heart. The symbol is N, the first alphabet. Oxygen. The symbol is O. Fluorine. That is the symbol is F, the first alphabet of it. And all these alphabets must be capitals. Capitals. Sulfur. The symbol is S. S is the symbol of sulfur. Very important. Here, potassium. This is not the first alphabet, but the symbol is K. K is the symbol of potassium. Very important, please don't get confused. P is not the first alphabet. Because phosphorus means P. Phosphorus, the first alphabet is P. So, please remember this. Potassium here, the symbol is K. Don't get confused, my dear friends. Boron, the first alphabet is B. B is the symbol of boron. Iodine, the symbol is I. Vanadium, the symbol of vanadium is V. Except this particular case, except in this potassium case, all the rest of the members, the symbol is the first alphabet. So I think, please try to remember, and all these alphabets are capitals. We are seeing the symbols. I request all of you, these all the things must be by heart and memorized. Now, this is cadmium. The name is cadmium. The symbol is capital C, small d. Very clear. Capital C and small d. Always the first alphabet is capital, the second alphabet is always small. Chlorine, capital C, small l. Platinum, capital P, small d. Palladium, capital P, small d. Barium, capital B, small a. Bromine, capital B, small r. Here, beryllium, capital B, small e. Helium, H-E. Neon, N-E. Lithium, L-I. Magnesium, M-G. Let us see the symbols. In this particular case, the symbols are basing on the Latin name. So please, this also we have to buy market. Now let us see the examples. This is copper. The Latin name is cuprum. The symbol is capital C, small u. Always the first alphabet is capital and second alphabet is small. That is common in all. Next is iron, ferrum, Fe. Potassium, kalium. The symbol is K. This is repetition. Already you have seen it. Now we are seeing why it is not the first alphabet. Potassium. The Latin name is kalium. And K is the symbol. Silver. Argentum. Ag. Important. Now lead. Plumber. The symbol is capital P, small b. Plumber. Next, sodium. Natrium. The Latin name is natrium. The symbol is Na, capital N, small a. Mercury, hydrogenum, Hd, capital H, small g. Tin, stannum, Sn, capital S, small o. Antimony, stibium, Sb, capital S, small b. Tungsten, wolfram, capital W. Gold, aurum, AU, capital A, small u. Now let us see some more elements whose names are basing on the names of the countries. You may by heart or may not by heart, no problem, but you should know it. But you should have the table in your notebook. Definitely please write it. Next, that is Europium. This name is coming after the name of the country Europe. Actually, after Europe, it is Europium. That symbol is EU. Silver, already we know the Latin name of it. Argentum. The name of Argentum is coming after Argentina. And the symbol is AG. Already we have discussed this. and American, this is basing on the name of the country America. The symbol is capital A, small a. Francium, France, basing on this name, we got this, right? Capital F, small r. Germanium, that is coming from the country name Germany, capital G, small e. Ruthenium, Russia, coming after the name of the country Russia. Ru, Polonium, coming after the name of the country Poland. Po, Californium, coming after California. Cf, Berkelium, city of Berkeley, capital B, small k. These elements are named after the name of the scientist. Curium is named after Madame Curie. All of you know about her. The symbol is Cm, capital C, small m. Mendelevium, named after the scientist Mendeleev. Mendeleev's periodic table was given by him. The symbol is Md, capital M, small d. Nobelium, named after the scientist Alfred Nobel. He was the person who started the Nobel Prizes. And the symbol is capital M, small o. Einsteinium, Albert Einstein. You all know about Albert Einstein, E is equal to mc square, famous equations. The symbol is capital E, small s. Fermium is named after Enrico Fermi, and the symbol is Fm. We know that even this Fermi we use in the distance, that is the value of 1 Fermi is equal to 10 to the power of minus 15 meters is called 1 Fermi. Already we have discussed this. So here also a name is there, Fermium, after Enrico Fermi, the symbol is Fm. Now you can see Neptunium, the name of the planet is named after the name of the planet Neptune. The symbol is Np, capital N, small p. Plutonium, Pluto, the name of the planet, Pu,